Righty, right, good afternoon. Welcome along to Drive Time with me, Barry Green, Liskeard Radio. All the usual stuff happening this afternoon, traffic, travel, news, weather, and of course the very, very best in music for you.
Oh, what a way to start the show, Joe.
So, I can guarantee you, listeners, this will be a Ramageddon-free zone.
It's time for the shopping forecast issued by the Get Off.
Get in touch, email, Facebook, lots of different ways you can get in touch with Liskeard Radio right now.
We all know and love it well.
Here on Liskeard Radio 87.7 FM,
turn the radio on.
Liskeard Radio broadcasts every year on the run-up to Christmas.
Love it.
There's one person that wants to put together a radio station. They then approached two or three other people in the town, and then it sort of grew from there, and I was part of that initial team.
Well, we started in 2012, I believe it was, when we first started, and it was just down the, up the road. It was in the top of a carpet shop, a guy called Dean Moore. He started it off,
and he said, I've got this crazy idea to set up a radio station in Liskeard. I said, oh, sounds interesting.
It was a bit Heath Robinson. We had to hire the gear, and I remember broadcasting, people drilling through walls in the teeming rain to try and get the aerial secured because it had fallen off the side of the building. And it was like, you know, you're working with all the gear and people coming in Macintoshes dripping water. And it was like a bit iffy, but it worked.
Cramped into this tiny studio, I mean, half the size of what we've got now and half the size of what we have here. But it was brilliant. It was nerve-wracking. I remember the very first show. But it was such great fun. I absolutely loved it.
From carpet shop to estate agents to school, this year Liskeard Radio are moving to their own premises in the centre of town.
Well, I think this year is exciting because we're in a new studio, which is where we are now, but this is the first time we've ever had our own studio, as it were. I mean, we're only a few weeks away, so there's a lot of boxes still to be unpacked, but we're getting there slowly, and it will be our first place that we've had that hasn't been either above a shop or at the back of a school or anything like that.
Okay, now, quick look at the weather. You do the weather report yourself. Welcome along. You know, my name's Simon, and we're going to be talking about this. We're going to be playing some tunes.
With only 2 weeks to the start of broadcast, founder and veteran presenter Dean Moore is running training sessions to get the DJs up to speed. And he knows how to get the best out of the platform.
It's a bit like fishing. You know, I describe this as an analogy. If depending on what you're playing or and what you're saying is your bait. So if you're gauging what would be called a call to action, for example, you know, give us a call now and you can win, you know, the latest CD from XYZ, you know, that's your bait. And then when the phone rings, that's your bite, you know, and that's how you can gauge interaction. But then now
we've got this and second year presenter Simon Crosbie can't wait to get started.
What I found last year was that the first 15 minutes or 20 minutes
a hectic. Sort
of blur and a hectic and a bag of nerves, and suddenly you get in the groove.
Yeah.
You go for it. And mine was a 2 hour slot, and then this year, and you get to the end of 2 hours, you go, oh man, can I not do another hour?
I know.
There was one time where I went, I wish the next guy wouldn't turn up so I could just keep going for a while.
Yeah. Well, it's also about telling your story and your relating to that one person that's listening. And I don't mean the one person like there's only one person listening, but when you're talking to somebody on air, you're talking to one person. It's you, you're, what are you doing? I'm doing this today, what are you doing?
I'm really good, man, how are you?
Really good, it's good to see you.
Good to see you.
The next day, it's a bigger group, and things are a bit more chaotic.
So, we're still doing items, and these items are Cornish's Best of the Best every hour,
yeah.
And Liskeard Rocks every hour.
Which was the...
On here,
yeah.
Laptop,
I get it, but
or
it's
turntable,
the... yeah.
Okay.
Work continues getting the new studio ready for the first day. And people keep arriving.
How are we doing, all right? Dean.
Martin.
Martin. Of course, yeah. You want a Barrett's box, don't you?
I do.
Okay. Yeah.
He's pissed.
What am I missing?
What are you missing?
Yeah, I want
You've got to turn the volume on.
That'll be it. Thanks, man. That's why I came in training.
Training, mate. Just got to put the volume up.
Slick and professional.
That's all right.
I was just testing you guys.
Yeah.
What's the tea, daughter? I'm baked beans.
To promote the station and raise money, musician and DJ Paul Program is hosting a quiz.
Which rock and roll icon was managed by Colonel Tom Parker, who was, of course, not a real colonel, not like Colonel Sanders, who...
And every chance is taken to plug the station.
Now, don't forget, on Monday, Liskeard Radio back on the air, 87.7 FM.
Liskeard Radio has tried all sorts over the last years to catch the eye of the town. Previous videos have gone viral on social media.
Question 60, which community radio station currently have a single out called Turn the Radio On?
Paul and his friend Keiron have been making music together for years. This year, they are writing their own publicity song, Turn the Radio On.
You know, we've always wrote songs. Then we started doing the adverts for radio, which was great because it was another form of writing and recording, but to a brief, and then there was an end result for it. So following that, I guess it was only a matter of time before we thought, let's do a song for the radio.
Well, what can we do? Well, we can help promote them with what we're good at is, well, what we're good at, the songwriting.
So that was the initial idea, and then at some point we just decided this bit of music we've been working on could be the song for the radio. And then Keiron come up with the Turn the Radio On line. He started off all the lyrics.
It's a good bit of fun. Last year, I think this number one was a parody of We Built This City on Rock and Roll with Sausage Rolls. So anything could happen.
As long as you sell more than Rage Against the Machine that week, I'll be happy. If you're born and you're at home,
on the first day of broadcast, and all the hard work is about to be put to the test. Dean is counting down the seconds with new host Jess Crosbie.
She is indeed, Keiron. Good morning, Keiron. Thank you very much for your news this morning. How are you this morning? Welcome along. This is our first broadcast. Yes, 7 a.m. this morning. We're here. I'm going to tell you about guests, co-stars and everything this morning. Oh, yeah.
What are you
going to
play next?
What do you fancy?
Ooh, I'm going to have a think. Do you care what genre you open?
No, it's got to be right across the board, I think.
Okay.
I'm thinking maybe a bit of the Fatback Band, something like that. Do you want to do the weather?
Me?
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. I can't see it, though. I have to turn it around. And we've got very misty places this afternoon with showery rain, but there could be the odd brighter spell developing as the showers ease. A brisk...
And Dean is getting back into it after a one-year break from presenting.
It's always nervous.
You're right.
First time round, thanks. So, no, it's all right. It's just a bit nervy, because you've got to remember what you're doing. It's like riding a bike without wheels.
A popular slot on The Breakfast Show is Thought of the Day, with regular guest Hella.
Of course it is. So, what have we got today, Hella?
What have we got today? Well, not taking things for granted. But one of the most important things is to see people. The person who opens the door for you. The person who pours your coffee.
You know, pay attention to the people around you. Absolutely valid point. And I think give people the respect they deserve.
Here we are, ladies and gentlemen, you're listening on Liskeard Radio. It's just gone 11 o'clock on 87.7. My name's Phil Seeva, and I'm here in the studio, and we've got guests. We decided that we were going to come up with this idea called Talk to the Traders. So today, our special guest is Alex and Michaela from Thompson's Opticians. Hello, guys, how are you?
Good morning.
You have been an advertiser on this radio.
Phil Seeva's mid-morning show concentrates on what's happening in the town.
For us. Hopefully, we do something back for you.
Definitely. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. So yeah, we see an increase every time we advertise. Yeah, so it's brilliant.
You see, ladies and gentlemen out there, are you listening to this? Because I think the reality of the situation is when people do advertise, it works. Otherwise, you wouldn't keep spending the money with us, maybe. But,
absolutely.
But there you go.
Right, hit something, goddammit.
Martin Calvert is setting up the sound system at the annual carol service at Wesley Methodist Church. The service will be broadcast over the airwaves. But setting up audio is never simple.
It's just clipping, it's not very good sound.
With the microphones at the front and the desk at the back, there is a bit of walking to do.
A way you can just stand there and whack out two verses or four bars or something, is that?
What, right now? Oh,
yeah? Fellow radio presenters Kate and Nick run the Caradon Youth Choir, the main performers tonight.
If they can just sing something.
The choir is still in the pews, and Martin needs them on stage to test the sound.
Do you think you've said one thing and you walk away from them?
You told them to sing?
Yeah. Just exactly what you did, I just want four bars. Right, hopefully the message got through this time.
Now in the right place, but the audio is still not sounding right.
It's just the it's the solo voice to the group voice, where the solo voice could be out front. If there's anything going from solo to group to solo to group, if the solos can be on the outskirts. But I mean, at the end of the day, it's not Royal Albert Hall, is it?
So,
yeah.
So Guy, who solos in the next It's just you three, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. You're fine where you are. Can you come and start?
Yeah.
So on the group ones, that should be right?
Yeah.
On the solo ones, I'm not sure.
So just be on hand. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, but basically it's those three, isn't it?
Okay, yeah, all right. But is the clip on being used, or is Andy sort of having the clip on at all? Or?
Is he? Oh, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. Do you want to check with him?
Okay.
Reverend Andy Day is leading the service.
Have you got a clip-on mic?
I have in my pocket.
You're
no, I haven't
it?
Got it in my pocket, it's there.
You're going to use that?
I think I'm going to use the clip-on, yes.
All right. Yes, he is. Yeah, so if he's talking, then use the clip-on.
Okay.
So you're all right with all that, aren't you?
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
I'll go upstairs then.
With the service about to start, Martin sets up the live feed for broadcast.
And I'm monitoring it on Periscope, so it's about 8 seconds behind. I've just heard myself. And I'm hoping it's not going to be that long a performance, that long a service, and the batteries are going to hold on.
Friends, welcome to our carol service this evening. For those of you who don't know who I am, my name's Andy, and I'm the new minister here. In the circuit. So at that point, I think I should say good evening to everyone who may well be listening on Liskeard Radio. Yes, folks, you are on the radio.
It was a good experiment. It went a little bit wrong halfway. But we managed to twist it around different sorts of devices and things, got it back on track, and it got to the end. So it was broadcast. So mission accomplished in terms of that.
So,
We have a guest in the studio this evening. I have a young lad by the name of Tyler Seymour. Good evening.
Good evening.
And he's not quite 17 years old and has already played twice at Looe Music Festival.
Tracy H uses her evening show to promote local artists.
It just flowed. It was like everything about Looe I love into one song.
Yep.
And it was amazing to write a song like that and then perform it in front of people.
And that was Hometown. That was your first single?
Yeah. That was the first one that when we decided to start recording my stuff, recording my music. So
fantastic. And so that was the song that you opened the festival with this year.
Yes.
But you're here tonight to sing your new single.
Yes.
Yeah, Christmas time,
yeah.
Because I go to quite a lot of gigs through the year and festivals and such like. So if I see a band that I like, I am that person that will hang around and collar them as they come off stage and just say, fancy coming on the radio. Get you to sign the lovely canvas.
Lovely.
Pick a colour, any colour. If you want to do a doodle as well. In previous years, we had people sign the desk, sign the radio desk, but it didn't wear too well. You know, got a few coffee stains and things on it. It wasn't looking too great, so we did the desk. But I wanted a way to remember the bands that I've had come in and play sessions or come in and chat. So yeah, I'm trying to fill it up. It's looking a bit bare still. It's only like it's last year and the year before. My favourite, probably my favourite session in terms of how quickly it happened and how much fun it was to do. King Dinosaur, they came in on my first show last year, set themselves up in the corridor of the school. We wired them into the desk and away they went. In the radio with you now, and with me live in the studio is Tyler Seymour from Looe, and he is going to perform his new single, Christmas Time, live for us now in the studio.
When I close my eyes, I see a land of dreams on
the town Christmas lantern parade and the switching on of the lights is always a well-attended event.
Halfway across the globe is a land of trees and snow.
Good evening, everybody. Can we please give a round of applause and a welcome to the Liskeard Town Silver Band.
Perfect.
DJ Jesse Foote is the compere this year.
Please, it's not raining though, because I've done this one before when it's been tipping it with lanterns. It's not much fun, but yeah, so we're thankful.
We have a big round of applause for the Liskeard Town Silver Band. The parade has begun, and if you look down the street, I can see lights heading this way. So huge round of applause for the fire brigade. Let's hear it for Father Christmas. It's John Deere, not reindeer.
No sooner does it start and the parade stalls, leaving Jesse to fill in the gap.
Many thanks to all the lantern makers. Lots of hard work went into that today. Again, thank you to Liskeard Radio for putting me in this position. Who loves Liskeard? Who loves Liskeard? Who loves Liskeard? Excellent. And the parade continues. Bye! I think it's a sample band.
I'm turning the PA off for that. There's no point in trying to compete with that. It's just noise over noise.
Okay, so we have a special guest here, Paul Hodge, who is...
Are you Deputy Grand Bard?
He's Deputy Grand Bard of the Cornish Dorset. He's a fluent speaker of Cornish, and he's going to count down in Cornuic.
Three, down, two, on, one!
Hey!
Look around you at all the amazing people who are here, all the amazing people with talent and beauty and meaning and value. Connect with one another, give thanks, have a great Christmas.
It's the final broadcast, and close friends Jason and Rich are making the most of the last few hours on air.
Oh, we've been friends, Rich. What would you say?
Let me think back now. We've known each other for well over 30 years, haven't we?
Blackies, barbers, hairbreddies, stocks, lightly falling, dark...
And they are having fun with sponsors, with the popular shopping forecast.
We love the two Ronnies.
Yeah.
We've been calling ourselves the two Rennies, because you never know what's coming up.
And for the final show, they have their own take on the famous two Ronnies sketch.
Tonight, your specialist subject is answering the previous question the previous contestant should have previously answered. What is the American president known as?
Crazy.
Correct. What does one generally do after a meal at Route 38 American Diner?
Tramp.
Correct. And your last question, what do Liskeard DJs do in preparation for next year's broadcast?
Juggle their spare time.
Correct.
This is Richie. I'm sitting in for Jason a minute while he makes me a cup of tea. He's usually got me running around doing it. Anyway, we're on a wind down now. This is the very last show of the year, Liskeard Radio, 87.7 FM.
Or whoever it is. After that. It's time to go, Rich.
It is. It's sad.
We've got 45 seconds.
45 seconds.
Happy Christmas, everyone.
Happy Christmas, everyone. Thanks for listening. And come back next year.
10 seconds and we're going home. See you next year, guys.
See you next year. Take care. Have a good Christmas, everyone.
To Liskeard Radio until next year then.
Until next year.
See you next year. Happy Christmas.
Had a busy day at work.